Hi, Andrey here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. Today we'll talk about circadian rhythms, or specifically we'll talk about how you can improve your circadian rhythm. If you have a hard time waking up in the morning, or feel sleepy during the day, or have problems getting to sleep at night, most probably you have a disrupted circadian rhythm. So in this video, we'll talk about how to fix it. In the past, we recorded a video on the fundamentals of circadian rhythm. So let's quickly recap what circadian rhythm is and why it's so critical. The circadian rhythm is the cyclical 24-hour period of human biological activities. And here we're talking about physical, emotional, mental activities. The circadian rhythm is managed by the master clock that is located in the SCN, or suprachiasmatic nucleus, in the hypothalamus. The SCN is based right behind the eyes, basically right in the middle of our head, and consists of only 20,000 neurons. Speaking of our brain's power, if 20,000 neurons can serve as the biological clock for the body, imagine what the rest, 86 billion neurons, can do for us. Unbelievable, right? Couple more points here. The first one is that circadian rhythm is not exactly 24 hours, it's longer than that. It ranges from 24.2 to 25 hours. And the sunlight, the environmental light, helps us stabilize the circadian rhythm to 24 hours. In general, sun plays a very critical role in circadian rhythms. And the other point is that though we have the master clock, we also have peripheral clocks across the body. Basically, every single organ of our body has its own biological clock. And the master clock and peripheral clocks talk to each other continuously. Okay, moving on to why circadian rhythm is so critical, so important. The circadian rhythm manages multiple processes in our body, such as hormone release, digestion, metabolism, body temperature, and many, many other things. So if you look at the hormone release, testosterone spikes right before we wake up. In my case, I wake up at about 5:30 a.m., so testosterone spikes at about 5 a.m. Cortisol, the stress hormone, spikes right after we wake up. So in my case, it's at about 6 a.m. Melatonin, the sleep hormone, spikes when we're going to bed. In my case, it's about 9 p.m. So as you can see, the circadian rhythm helps us to get the right hormones at the right times. Now imagine it's all messed up. So cortisol spikes at 1 a.m. instead of 6 a.m. So I wake up in the middle of the night and I don't want to sleep anymore. I stay in the bed, kind of sleep till 6 a.m. But when I get up at 6 a.m., I don't feel alert and energized since I don't get my cortisol spike. Similar to this, imagine that melatonin spikes at 2 p.m. instead of 9 p.m. So I feel sleepy during the day and then I have a hard time to get asleep at night. So it's not fun, right? Now let's talk about practical ideas how to improve circadian rhythms. And the first two ideas are related to light, since light is so crucial in stabilizing circadian rhythms. And that proximity of eyes and the SCN, suprachiasmatic nucleus, is by design, since light is the biggest stimulus for the circadian rhythms. So the first idea is to get exposed to morning sun. So if you wake up in the morning and it's already sunny outside, try to spend some time, 2-3 minutes, looking at the sun. So you'll tell your master clock it's morning time, and the master clock will align all of its processes based on that information. The second idea is try to avoid light in the evening as much as you can, especially after the sunset, and especially the light from electronic devices. If you can stay away from electronic devices altogether, it's great, it's fantastic. If you can't do that, try to turn on the blue light blocking filter on your computer and your phone. Usually it's a standard feature for many electronic devices. Okay, and the last idea in this external cues, EX stands for external, is related to temperature and noise. Usually the temperature and noise levels are highest during the day and lowest during the night. So the idea is to mimic nature and create a cool and nice and quiet environment for your sleep. So basically keep your bedroom cool and quiet. The next three ideas are related to our internal processes. So this IN stands for internal. And here we have two levers. The first lever is our eating pattern, and the second lever is our level of physical activities. So, idea number four is to have a healthy breakfast. Not a snack, not a coffee, but a real breakfast. In my case, usually I have my breakfast at about 10 a.m. and it's full of vegetables and proteins, since proteins play so critical, so crucial role in our body operations. Okay, so the next idea is to have early dinner. So you'll have your body enough time between dinner time and going to bed to digest the food and move the food from the stomach to intestines for absorption. Final idea for today is to work out early, early in the morning. So you wake up every single organ, every single system of your body as early as possible. By the way, you can get a bonus point if you combine morning workout with the morning sun. So basically you'll get a morning run or cycling trip outside. Probably this is the best way to align your circadian rhythms. A couple more points. One is to have a consistent schedule, since it takes days, sometimes weeks, to align your circadian rhythms to a desired schedule. And the second one is, I have a homework for you. So the study of the circadian rhythm is called chronobiology. And one of the biggest experts in this field is Sachin Panda from Salk Institute. So if you go to YouTube, search for Sachin Panda, so you can watch his video. He has usually provided a lot of details, a lot of insights on the circadian rhythms. Basically, that's it for today. I hope you like this video. If so, give us a like. And also, if you know someone who have a hard time waking up in the morning, or feel sleepy during the day, or having problems getting to sleep at night, please send the link of this video to that person. I hope it will help that person to improve their circadian rhythms. That's it for today. See you next time. Bye.